Hey, this is Chris Summers, the Summers team. We're going to be talking about new construction. We're going to be talking about tax abatement with NCQ. Julie Hankins, she just joined here. Give a couple of people some waves. Boom, boom. Julie, I'm going to invite you right now. Hopefully she comes on. Well, ho, look at that.
Hello.
Hey, hey. What's happening?
Living the dream.
Well, you're smiling, Julie. You're looking good. I don't see kids running around right now.
I'm hiding in my office. I've told them to stay upstairs. I'm hiding.
Is your office like sacred new construction land, are they allowed in?
They are. It's, you know, normally Lego land out there where they will play, but
nice.
They're nice and loud. And also my office has turned into a bit of a stashing point because we are like doing some painting and getting things ready. And so it's my office is not as normal as what it usually is. So,
hey, I have this nice, you know, thing behind me, but if I go this way, it's a nightmare. But you know, we got spring cleaning opportunity. We got, you know, post or virus opportunity cleaning catch up. But for people that are just joining, Julie, I call her NCQ. She's new construction queen, expert new construction on the Summers team. Julie, do you just want to kind of give a quick update who you are and what you do?
Absolutely. So Julie Hankins with the Summers team. I specialize in new construction. I've been in the real estate world for the last 16 years. Do a lot of investing myself, but mainly I work with new construction in the East Kensington, Fishtown, South Kensington, Riverwards area, and I represent one of the largest builders, Riverwards Group. So it's great being with the Summers team in Keller Williams, Philadelphia. You know, it's a little bit about me.
I mean, that's a lot right there. I mean, it's great that you're with us. You know, you are certainly one of the pinnacles in the industry and working with one of the top developers in the city, if not the top, you know, Riverwards. And maybe we'll do a plug for that going into next week. But, yeah, big picture, you know, we kind of have, you know, this, obviously there's this drama going out there. There's some things happening. People are at home. You know, not as many people out there because it's really not allowed in the state of Pennsylvania. Right. Other than virtual tours, but you know, let me know what do you think about, you know, I kind of think about this when you combine interest rates at super low, probably the lowest ever, combined with the 10-year tax abatement, you know, combined with some of the projects that you're representing, like what does that look like to you and to some of the buyers that, you know, that are going under, you know, properties for the developments?
Well, I mean, you really know a lot about with how big and huge that 10-year tax abatement helps us in the city of Philadelphia. When you're talking construction side of things and how costly construction is, especially in Philadelphia, having that tax abatement then makes it that much more affordable for that first-time home buyer. So a lot of what I'm seeing is we see more first-time home buyers and some second-time buyers, most certainly. But you have a lot of first-time home buyers, and for first-time home buyers, it's all about monthly payment. And anytime you can keep that monthly payment low, maybe lower than what you're paying in rent, you know, and monthly payments in conjunction with your taxes. So City of Philadelphia, they did a whole reconstruction of how property taxes are looked at, how taxes in general are looked at. And taxes at one point in Philadelphia were, you couldn't, they were so low that you couldn't touch them. So it only made sense that they redid their tax system. But now, you know, okay, to buy a new construction home, your land taxes are now around that $1,200 to $2,000 mark, depending on where you're at. Did you buy a condo? Did you buy a single family townhome? You know, how big of a townhome did you get? Are you in Northern Liberties? Are you in Center City? So it's all about where they value that land portion. But that's a huge difference versus now you have a home that's resale and it's valued at $500,000. And so your taxes are $6,000 plus. So the tax abatement is huge for first-time home buyers and anybody looking to keep their monthly payment low. And on top of that, with the low mortgage rates, 3% for 30-year, that's really good. That's
I mean, it's like crazy. Like, you know, for owner-occupants, for investors, like, you know, this is the time to kind of take advantage of this. You know, at some point, you know, prices might go up, rates can go up, prices can still go down, rates can come up when things loosen up. But like for most people that rent in Fishtown or South Kensington, Julie, like, yeah, we see the rental prices out there. There are people paying, you know, well over $2,000 a month, you know, just for like a basic home, you know, at the Riverwards or at Kensington Courts, for example, you know, with rates as low as they are right now, combined with the abatement and maybe a, you know, a 5 or 10% down payment, like what does that look like for a homeowner, you know, with just a ballpark mortgage payment?
Yeah, so I mean, their ballpark mortgage payment when you are, we have two left at the 400,000 mark, and they, you know, if they're putting 5% down, just to do quick math on my handy dandy calculator here, at 3% interest rate, you know, 30-year term, you're looking. Of course, I did it wrong. Give me 1 minute. 30 years.
I'm pretty impressed with this handy dandy calculator.
I love it.
Yeah.
Your payment, just mortgage alone, is $1,600.
I mean, yeah, think about that. You know, maybe you get a roommate if you want to, you know, kind of offset your mortgage payment, but, you know, taxes, insurance, you know, fill in the blank. You know, you get a full new construction home with parking.
Exactly. Parking. I mean, I was battling with an appraiser earlier today about the value of parking. So it's, you know, parking in the city, in these areas, you're at least, if I'm being conservative, $25,000.
Yeah, I don't know what.
It's 35 to 45 that you're looking at. And that's, people are going to pay that. They're not just going to pay, oh, I'll pay $5,000 more for parking. Like, that's not how it works.
Yeah, I mean, out of pet peeve of mine, Julie, I've fought with a few appraisers over the years, not that many, you know, that would only value parking at some, you know, ridiculous amount. I don't know if that gets me more upset or Governor Wolf, you know, with not having real estate essential, but we won't go there for this part. But a lot of people that might watch this video afterwards, and if anyone has a question, I see Jay Ash, you know, just joined. I think she's probably a tax abatement expert too. Those guys are guaranteed rate. If anyone has a question, throw it in, you know, the IG chat. You know, we'll have this on video too. But Julie, some people aren't aware of the tax abatement changes that are going into next year. Can you just kind of like highlight? I mean, obviously some properties will still have it, some won't.
Absolutely. So it's going to be dependent on the builder and how well they know the changes and how well they know the city of Philadelphia. So for instance, if they're getting their permits, the big thing is the permits, is as long as the permits are in by December 31st, 2020, it will stay with the old tax abatement, which you will still get 10 years. So if those permits were submitted by that date and you settle in 2021, you're still going to get the old tax abatement, the old 10 years. If they submit them January 2021, the new abatement comes into play. And what that pretty much is it's pretty much a five and a half year abatement as opposed to 10 years when you collectively add all of them together. But it's a stepping. So the first year you get the full 10 years, the full abatement, where you're only paying tax on the land portion. The next year you're now paying the full land tax and then 10% of the value of the home, of the structure. And then the next year it goes to 20% value of the structure, 30, 40, all the way down until year 10, where you're paying 90%.
Yep. I mean, I think the big picture now, Julie, you know, is like if I'm a home buyer or like we're talking to buyers, yeah, if you postpone this decision for a year, yeah, there still might be some developments, you know, that will trickle over, you know, for the, you know, that they got the building permit in before the end of the year. But what I see happening, there's not a lot of new construction inventory hitting the market now. There might be some the second half of the year, you know, but you know, with what's available now, with knowing that you can get the 10-year tax abatement now, knowing that you could get that 3%, give or take, interest rate now, to me, it just seems like, you know, the perfect formula, you know, for people that might be sitting on the fence, like the jump in. Would you agree with that?
I would. Yeah. I mean, getting on something now, even though we're during the COVID-19 era, when you have interest rates as low as they are, it's, you know, there's an opportunity here. And on top of it, you could get a home that already has the full 10-year tax abatement this year, and you could maybe, okay, instead of settling pre-COVID-19, you would be settling June. Well, now you're settling August because, you know, everyone's hoping. I mean, eventually we're going to have to open up. The economy's going to have to open up. I mean, it can't stay closed in forever. We're going into warmer seasons, so that's going to help with this virus. All of those things. And yeah, I mean, if you're going under contract now, guess what? We have virtual tours that we're doing. We have that available to people. And I sell pre-construction on things that aren't built. So I'm constantly painting that picture for people without them being able to physically walk through something. So when people say you can't sell homes during this time, okay, you don't have to physically walk through, but if you look off of floor plans and you see pictures and you see these virtual tours, sure. And you, guess what? You're going to be able to get into that home and do your walkthrough and do a home inspection before it settles. Like that's most certainly. So you're not going to just be hopping into the home day of settlement.
And I think with some of these builders, Julie, developers, I mean, they have the reputation. It's not like it's something unknown. You know, at Kensington Court, so many properties have already settled, you know, so yeah. The virtual part is virtual, you know, but there's also something tangible. And I think the good news is, I just have to do, you know, a quick shout out to the KW Philadelphia and the Summers team and our agents, like any type of, you know, buyers that are out there, they should be contacting us if they're interested to buy. Like, you know, we have a lot of the new construction inventory. You're working with Kensington Courts at Hancock 5.
Yeah,
less than 600,000, a block away from where I live. You could be my neighbor. I'm not sure if that's good or bad. I think it's good. You know, less than 600,000 with garage parking. There's only two left. Yeah, we just listed four on Fletcher Street. Yeah, super nice part of Fishtown proper. They're just put up there. We have a few other ones that are out there. We got Martha 8 homes around the corner from Kensington Courts, you know, below 450. So, but other than that, like, I look at the new construction inventory, Julie, there's not a lot out there.
There's not. And I mean, the one thing to also hold on to is that, yeah, Kensington Courts is there. You listed all the ones that you have, but Riverwards Group, they're looking at other, you know, projects. There's stuff that they have in the mix, and there's stuff that they're going to be opening up that's around the corner from Kensington Courts that has a similar floor plan to that stacked unit that's going to hit that first time home buyer mark.
Yeah, I think people will be like, that's kind of like an IPO. Yeah, everyone wants in. You got the owner occupants, you want the investors. Like, yeah, you know, I'm sure you're going to have, you know, fun with that. You know, taking, like,
I already have my list going.
Oh, I'm sure that, you know, it might be, you know, first come, first serve, you know, you got to know someone. It's like a VIP line. Let me maybe just ask you one more question, and then maybe we'll kind of do kind of like a little teaser for next week. Any like unusual mechanics that you're seeing with some of the new construction settlements that are happening now with the city? Maybe the certificate of occupancy might be in, you know, maybe it's coming in an hour or tomorrow, or like, are you seeing anything like a little unusual just with the city, you know, their resources are low, not every inspector is working and so forth?
A little bit. Yeah. So, you know, a lot of this before the shutdown happened, you had inspectors that had done walkthroughs of the property, and they have to go back, get their supervisor to sign and stamp and give you the official certificate of occupancy. Well, that part's not happening. So we're getting letters from those inspectors saying, hey, look, we have provided, we've done the walkthrough. Once the city's up and running, we'll be able to give you the official certificate. But I'm telling you, this home has been done and completed. And that has passed for lenders. So right. we've gotten stuff settled, new construction, with just that letter. And I advised another, a buyer that I had with Tiffany, we were having problems getting that CO. And I said, hey, look, let's go back to whoever your inspector was, see if we can get that letter so that we can get this moving along. And that's exactly what happened and took place.
Awesome. I would think that any lender with some brain cells, you know, would accept that. I know some lenders can have all sorts of weird overlays, but I would imagine 4 out of 5, yeah, that should be fine.
Right. And, you know, it also helps whenever you have the appraisal that says that it's done, completed, and ready
Correct.
To go. So when you
Correct.
Have that, you're the lender's that much ahead of it. Yeah.
Right. What are your thoughts are? I imagine, you know, some of the people that you work with, you know, maybe it's Mo, you know, at Riverwards or someone, you know, that, you know, maybe to kind of get a developer's perspective of what's kind of happening, you know, with this market, you know, the city, you know, the cry. Are you open to maybe bringing him on next week, an Instagram Live around
Absolutely.
This time next Friday?
We need to do that because, I mean, as much as, you know, you and I are behind the scenes doing these videos, doing Zoom videos, doing any sort of training that we can do to keep ourselves up to speed with what's going on, he's doing the same thing on the back end with the Philadelphia Builders Association and all that's there. And he's talking not only to other builders and other contractors and subcontractors, but as well as, you know, people involved in the city, the government, the politicians. So he knows a lot of what's going on. He knows more somewhat than what we do.
Right.
But yeah, I mean, he just like everyone else is hopeful for this to open back up, and they're gonna, they already got like a certificate to be able to start back up in construction on the 20th. So next week, but they have to make sure that their subs abide by all of those rules that are put in place.
Correct.
And they also know and understand that, you know, you may have subs that don't want to go in because of COVID-19, and that's all fine and good. And you may have subs that don't really understand it and may not do what needs to be done to, you know, wear the protective gloves, wear the mask, do the things that they're supposed to do to make sure that they can build, and then maybe it might get shut down. So they're going to roll the dice. They're going to see how things go, and next week get up back up to building, see what we can do. But the biggest thing is, hey, you know, for buyers, not only do you have the tax abatement as well as the incentive on interest, but Riverwards with Kensington Courts, they're offering incentives right now for people if they want to go under contract right now for during this time. So if a buyer's out there or knows of, you know, is interested in learning more, just, you know, contact us, contact myself, Chris, our team, and we can tell you what those incentives are, because they're really good incentives.
Well, and not for nothing, I think Mo Rushdie might have been having a sixth sense or something, because he just popped on here. He just had a hello.
Yeah.
So yeah, shout out to Mo. I don't know if Mo's aware that he might, you know, be on here next week. I think he'll say yes. I mean, you know better than me. Yeah, but it'd be great to hear that developer side of things. And I think it's great that, you know, it on top of the 10-year tax abatement, on top of a mortgage rate of 3%, hey, here's, you know, some more incentives. Like, that's like a trifecta right there. And quick shout out to, you know, I know Mo, you know, a lot of, you know, friends of mine are heavily involved with BIA, and I'm sure they're doing, you know, everything they can on their lobbying front, you know, on our end. You know, GPAR is under the Greater Philadelphia Association of Realtors, is under the PAR umbrella, Pennsylvania Association of Realtors. But, you know, all the lobbying and everything I'm kind of seeing happening, you know, behind the scenes, you know, I guess Wolf is just kind of like, you know, doing his thing. But I would imagine, you know, as the days go by, as the weeks go by, you know, I think things will obviously sooner or later, you know, open up. Obviously, like you said, you know, safety first, with all the precautions, you know, necessary and applicable, you know, things can kind of still happen, you know, with, you know, those, the safety, you know, being in mind first.
Exactly. I mean, we're not going back to the way we were before. and there's a lot of good that has come out of this. I mean, heck, what we're doing right now, we're going to be doing more of that. You know, we're going to continue to do more. It's making us be more creative on how to sell. It's making us be more creative on how to market. And it's also being aware that, guess what? We're not going to be able to be huggers anymore.
Yeah, we could do our virtual fist bumps, you know, some elbows or whatnot. But you're right, Julia. And I think, you know, it really kind of, you know, that's kind of like the reason why we've done a few of these Instagram Lives, kind of talk about some of the changes, some of the evolution, you know, and, you know, in our industry, you know, with the summer stay, like we've always been doing, you know, property, you know, videos, virtual tours, but you can see how much more important that is. And as we get to the other side, you know, real estate marketing, video marketing, having information becomes that much more important, you know, whereas in a super strong market, it's still important, you know, but you know, things are kind of flying off the shelf a little bit. Mortgage companies are stepping up their game. Title companies are stepping up their game. And, you know, the ones that aren't, obviously, are going to be left behind. So, you know, kudos to what you guys are doing over there. Do you have anything else you want to add before we kind of wrap up today?
I mean, for the most part, I think we talked a lot about what we have going on. I mean, at Kensington Courts, there's 15 homes left. We actually just got one under contract. So during this time, you can go under contract.
Yeah.
And so, you know, it's be careful, be safe, be smart. Be smart. Think about what you're doing. So, yeah.
I mean, my mother texted me the other day, Julie, and she goes, "Can you send me a photo of your mask?" And I'm like, "I don't have a mask. I haven't made it that far." And she goes, "Check your mail." And sure enough, I opened my mail, and she, you know, she must have sewed, you know, a mask for both Stephanie and I. So I have a homemade mask from Virginia. So, yeah.
That's nice. And now with the Governor Wolf on Sunday, if you go outside, you have to wear a mask. Our neighbor is doing the same thing, and she has kids' masks. So I'm like, all right, we're going to have to hit her up for five of them because.
Right. And, you know, we'll get sell some masks. But anyway, Julie, thanks for being on here today.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. Thanks for the people that join. Yeah, we'll have, you know, a link for this where people, you know, can watch it, or, you know, we'll put it out there on YouTube. But stay strong, right, Julie?
Stay strong, stay healthy, stay safe.
Stay healthy.
Questions, come to us.
And I love the final see you soon, because we will be seeing everyone soon. Yes. At settlement tables, even if it's virtual on video, but we'll be seeing everyone soon on the other side. So have Absolutely. Have an awesome weekend. I think we're talking on Sunday.
We are.
So thanks again. Everyone have a great weekend.
Yeah, have a good one.
All right. Bye, Julie. Bye, NCQ.
Bye.